National Tripartite Committee has increased this year's minimum wage to 8 cedis 80 pesos from the initial figure of 7 cedis last year, representing a 10% increment.
Sector Minister of Employment and Labour Relations, Haruna Idrisu, promised to get the figure gazetted by the Attorney General to impose sanctions on companies which would pay below the amount.
Haruna Idrisu made the announcement at a news conference in Accra. The National Tripartite Committee comprises government, organized labor, and the Ghana Employers Association. The committee meets every year to announce the minimum wage, and this year, the figure has been pegged at 8 cedis 80 pesos, representing 10%.
Agreed by consensus, a 10% increase in the national daily minimum wage from 8 cedis to 8.80 Ghana pesos, Ghana cedis. A new legislative instrument will be laid in parliament on it. On national daily minimum wage, non-compliance will be sanctioned.
Some labor economists and employees have described the increase as woefully inadequate. But the president of the Ghana Employers Association, Terence Darko, disagrees.
We cannot pay. We appreciate some of the difficulties our employees are going through. So we must increase the compensation. But we should not also kill the goose that lays the golden egg.
Secretary General of the Trade Union Congress, Dr. Yaba, warned foreign nationals not to underpay Ghanaian workers. He again charged the minister to equip the inspectorate division to monitor companies who flout the payment directive.
We will have to, together as social partners, ensure that employers comply with this new minimum wage, whether they are in the formal or informal sector. We are also asking the government to ensure that minimum wage earners are not going to pay income tax.
Reacting to that, Haruna Idrisu spoke about plans to recruit 50 graduates to conduct the monitoring.
I've asked the Factories Inspectorate Directorate in conjunction with the Youth Employment Agency to recruit 50 graduates trained specifically and purposely for factory inspection so that we would get them onto the field to support this particular exercise.
In another development, the sector minister again hinted of placing an ally before parliament to regulate activities of domestic workers.